So Satpanch is the creators of our Ayurveda. So we have to mainstream it, that is the thing. Already I have attended one seminar which has helped me to conduct this seminar. The second thing is, if you want to create some sort of comparison, there are two comparisons. One is contemporary comparison, second is current comparison. Then comparing to that of the primitive society of Chinese medicine, Tibetan medicine, Byzantine medicine, Incan medicine, Aztec medicine, Mayan medicine, and various other civilizations, medicines, tribal native medicines, as well as incantations and potions that they have practiced and they have administered with a lot of people, which we are having lot of historical records as well as inscriptive evidences. Even we are having thousands of practical evidences with those people who are just endangered now. So first thing is comparing the contemporary society of Ayurveda, how far Ayurveda is great. That is understandable. Second thing is compare it with present, current, modern medical science, how far is Ayurveda. There are four things. One is number of new diseases. And second thing is there are number of new effective medicines. And the people's mind setup is different, body adaptability is different, the population has grown to a greater extent. That is number three. So we are having a lot of disturbances and differences like that. Number one is more population. Different mind setup of people, different physical adaptability of the people. New diseases they have now. Third thing is new effective drugs are there. Number fourth, new responsible technologies they have emerged. At this time, how we are going to mainstream Ayurveda? How we are going to tackle new diseases in Ayurveda? Number one, how we are going to meet new technologies in Ayurveda? Is it going to be against that? Are going to be complementary to each other? Are create a substitute technology for that? Number four, is it having already an existing technology which is equal or greater than that? These four questions who are going to answer? Is it going to abide or incumbent with the modern technology? Are independent of existence is possible? Are already there is a substitute for that which is greater or equal? These things we have to decide. And new effective medicines, they have come. And the people, their adaptability is entirely different. So this is what we call mainstreaming Ayurveda. Before mainstreaming Ayurveda, you must not compare the contemporary Ayurveda period, but Ayurveda with the current period and current necessity. Most of the people, the greatness of Ayurveda is already proved in its earliest reference. But as effective reference, it is not yet proved. Most of the Ayurvedic colleges and conferences, they are simply like a parrot repeating the same thing, like those people were nomads, they were in nudity and obscurity and that we developed everything. So earliest reference of medical knowledge, more than the papyrus medical philosophy of the Egypt, more than the Megaria medical philosophy of the West, more than the Byzantine Admira Physiata medicology that existed in the ancient civilizations, more than the Babylonian and Sumerian civilizations' perspective of physical anatomical structures that they have made before 4,500 years. More than that, we have been advanced and we have developed a lot of things like rhinoplasty, plastic surgery, hematology, gynecology, obstetrics, then osteopathy, innumerable things we have developed. Nobody is going to deny that. But effective reference towards the present trend is an area where we have to contemplate. And number two, there are innumerable things with modern and as well as our traditional medical sciences clash. So it is a clash between modernity and our ancestralism. So most of the things they have accepted, few things they have refuted, few things they have not clarified or they have not been clarified. Either they have not clarified or they have not been clarified. Most of the portions are unknown to modern medicine. Most of our Ayurvedic syllabi and the contents are unknown, unexposed to modern medicine. So we have five dimensions, where they have refuted, where they have appreciated and accepted, where they are not known of anything about that subject at all. Like we say three dosha, till now they don't understand what is vata, pitta and sleshma. And still apart from your mere pulse meter, they cannot interpret anything from a nadi. They cannot understand anything from a nadi, except understanding the palpitation, except understanding the normal cardiac functioning or any respiratory arrest, or any other affliction or any other disturbance, they cannot predict something more with the general physical health of human beings. So these things are unknown areas. So accepted area, refuted area, unknown area, accepted and refuted area, refuted and accepted area. So these things are the five divisions which we are carrying with the modern as well as traditional medicinal clash. Now coming to mainstreaming, what is mainstreaming? If you say about mainstreaming, there must be also some other levels. What are they? What is mainstreaming and what is elsewhere? Other than mainstream, There are three things. One is merge, second is upstreaming, third thing is mainstreaming. Apart from this, there is extinction or obsoleteness. We will leave all of these things. There is mainstreaming. Mainstreaming means, in spite of existence of various entities, if still a thing is dominating, it is a benevolent domination, still something out of its productivity, out of its services, out of its magnanimity and greatness and richness, something that rules the society is in the mainstream. And that which is not there, but still existing as an alternative or complementary, that is known as substream. That which has no identity at all, that which is already a part or already merged as a part in the mainstream, having no individuality or individual identity, that is known as merge. Now Ayurveda is going to merge. Because most of the people, they don't have any, except the syllabus and the place where they sit and study, everything they have followed like that of the mainstream of the allopathy only. Their practice, their behavior, their ashram, everything is now slowly getting merged into the mainstream of allopathy. So to take that submerging system of this Ayurveda into allopathy, as well as already existing substream section of Ayurveda to the mainstream, we have to do two things. We have to create the individuality and uniqueness of Ayurveda so that it is not mixed with allopathy at all. So that thing is not there. Now if you are the student, as well as the scientist, as well as the scholar, if they themselves accept that they need a prosthetic tool or a limb of the allopathic guidance, then that proves that they are handicapped, that the system is incomplete. So mainstreaming means, number one, philosophy. Philosophy should be clear. Second thing is process. It should be more effective. And the third thing is resources. That is the upadhan. We must have abundant resources, inexhaustible resources. That is the mula dhatu or mula dravya. For Ayurveda, we need lot of herbs, rasa, paṭana, dhatu, veshaja, aushadha, innumerable things we require. Where are those mula dhatus? It should be abundant. Growing population, growing diseases, then resources should also grow. Now there are three compacts. In cultivation, there are three compacts. Food versus herb versus fuel. Food cultivation versus herbal cultivation versus fuel. Are they going to tackle the food issue by cultivating food crops? Are they going to cultivate jatropha and other things for fuel? This thing, they have to hire Mars and Jupiter. They have to hire Mars, Jupiter, Venus and other planets. Each and every planet they have to use for all of these things. One planet for energy cultivation, one planet for herbal cultivation, one for food. That is the thing, food fuel and this herbal or medicinal value compact is now existing. How they are going to use it? So it should have a philosophy, it should have a process, it should have the fundamentals, what we call mula dhatus in the form of the resources. Apart from that, public demand. Mainstreaming is not made by any book or by any educational institution. It is made by public demand. Who makes a hero? Who makes a zero as a hero? And still wants the zero to be the hero. Who makes that? These only the people. Who makes fit for nothing fellow to be a political head or ruler of a nation?